One of them likes to fly from tree to tree. The other fends off attackers with his prickly skin. Sugar gliders and hedgehogs. Soon, the two exotic animals could be allowed as pets in Omaha. City Council's considering a new plan that would legalize them. And KETV News Watch 7's Todd Andrews is live with this new story at 6.
And you may soon see them at stores around Omaha and across the metro. It turns out the two animals are legal across the state of Nebraska, but they're just not here in Omaha yet. The Humane Society says it researched them thoroughly and found no reason not to recommend them. This little one.
Yeah, they're really prickly.
May not look like your average household pet, but he soon could qualify as one in Omaha. Beneath a heavy layer of defensive spines, and in this case, just waking up, is a hedgehog.
Everything we hear about these animals are that they'll make great family pets.
Mark Langan of the Humane Society refers not just to hedgehogs, but to sugar gliders as well. Both exotic animals you'd normally see at a zoo and presently only legal as pets outside of town. But now the city council is looking to open the door. Langan and his team researched the animals at the council's request.
We determined that they pose no health risk. They're not a dangerous animal, both very sociable animals.
Zoological experts agree, but had words of caution regarding both animals for people thinking of buying one.
Hedgehogs are very interesting little creatures. They are adorable. I mean, you can't look any cuter than see it in the face, but keep in mind that hedgehogs are nocturnal. So they're moving around when you're sleeping. They don't want to be moving around during the daytime when you want to.
As are these little ones, experts say. Plus, they're difficult to care for, have sharp teeth and claws, have no ability to be house trained. When they eat, they scatter food over a 2-foot radius. Plus, they can bark during the night.
Well, I know they're very reclusive and hide in things. I know that I've known people who have had sugar gliders, and they can be very noisy at night.
That said, council officials tell us they're set to follow the recommendation of the Humane Society. So you could soon see these at a pet store near you. And the council will hold a hearing on that plan early next month. We're told a vote could happen as soon as the week after that. Melissa?
All right. Very interesting. Todd Andrews reporting live. Thank you.